Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover most important MCQs for upcoming SSC JEE exam. Fluid mechanics part I will cover. Question is, when a body is placed over a liquid, it will sink down. If this is liquid surface, it is sinking down means going down. W is downward force and force due to buoyancy. Or up thrust is upward. If W is greater than FB, then only it will sink down. So C is your correct answer. Gravitational force is more than the up thrust of the liquid. This one already discussed. The property by virtue of which a liquid opposes relative motion between its different layers is called as its viscosity. Euler's dimensionless number relates the following. Euler's number, inertia force divided by pressure force root over. So inertia force and gravity force, this is for third number, viscous force and inertia force. This is for Reynolds number, inertia force divided by viscous force. Then viscous force and buoyancy force, pressure force and inertial force. Pressure force and inertial force, D is your correct answer. When a body is floating in a liquid, it displaced lightly, it oscillates about. If body is like this, if it is oscillates, your condition is meta center, then your gravity, center of gravity G and center of buoyancy. If you are oscillating like this, it oscillates about your meta center. D is your correct answer. Question is, in an immersed body, center of pressure is, center of pressure, H star formula is Ig sin square theta divided by A, H bar, A is area, and H bar is distance of center of gravity. H bar is distance of center of gravity. This quantity is positive quantity. So, H star is greater than H bar. Center of pressure is below the center of gravity. C is your correct answer. Sometimes problem also they may ask. So, the direct formula you have to put. A vertically immersed surface is shown in the below figure. The distance of its center of pressure from the water surface is how much? So here x bar is the CG distance. Center of pressure H star, we have to calculate Ig sin square theta. Here theta is 90 degree. So we will put sin square theta equal to 1. Ig is moment of inertia. It's BdQ by 12. Then area into h bar instead of h bar, they are writing distance of CG is x bar plus x bar. So here h star equal to Ig is BdQ by 12 into 1 by area is B into D into x bar plus x bar. BB cancel, d square by 12 x bar plus x bar. This is your center of pressure. So B is your correct answer. Sometimes they may give some values also, B value, D value. Then we have to find out H star value. And X bar value also they will give. Just put the formula, put the values in the formula and you will get your answer. Within 1 minute you can solve. Then steady flow occurs when, steady flow means property with respect to time. This is zero. In case of steady, in case of uniform, it will come position. Then direction and magnitude of velocity at all points means position, so not possible. Velocity of successive fluid particles at any point is the same at successive periods of time, yes. This is correct. With time, then the magnitude and direction of velocity do not change from point to point. Point to point means, again, position, not possible. Streamline patterns are identical in each plane. Time not mentioned, so D also not possible. B is your correct answer. A flow is called supersonic if supersonic flow, subsonic flow is Mach number less than 1, and your sonic flow, Mach number equal to 1, Mach number is greater than 1 is supersonic, and Mach number very very greater than 1, it's hypersonic. So, supersonic gas, Mach number is between 1 and 6. C is your correct answer. In a forced vortex flow, the velocity of flow everywhere within the fluid is, we know for forced vortex flow, angular velocity is constant, or V equal to R omega, V by R equal to omega is constant. And one more formula is important here, H equal to B square by 2G or omega square R square by 2G. If forced vortex flow, they will ask for height of the parabola. You have to use this formula. R is the distance from center. Omega is the angular velocity of rotation. H they will ask. H is this one. Height of parabola H. So, from here, maximum, no, minimum, no, zero, no, non-zero finite, D is your correct answer. This is the end of this part. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.